The slope of a line segment can also be found using the coordinates of the endpoints of the line segment. The slope is a vertical change over the horizontal change. If you want, we can utilize this formula. The vertical change is equal to yA minus yB divided by xA minus xB for any two points, AB with coordinates xy. Determine the slope of the line segments with the endpoints negative 5, negative 4, and 1, negative 2. So I am to determine these endpoints, I am to determine the slope. Now, what do I know just by drawing it? That the slope will be positive, because as I go left to right, that is if I draw it left to right, that this is going to go uphill. Other than that, not too much more do I know. However, I'm just going to make my box like I did before here. And I could get the slope here, and I could get my horizontal change and my vertical change, but here, this is delta x, or my change of x. Better known, if you want to know how far long the side is, you just simply take xa minus xb, which is what we see in the formula right here in the denominator. In the numerator, what we see is yA minus yB. And if you want to get the length of this, of the vertical, the change of y, would simply just take yA minus yB. Now, does order matter, A or B? Well, slope, if you're using this formula, I would encourage you to use to ensure one thing, that the A's come before B's, or the B's become before the A's in the subscript. As long as you keep that consistent, you're going to be okay. So I'm going to determine the slope here. So slope, as given by my formula, it is yA minus yB divided by xA minus xB. So my slope is going to be equal to, well, I'm going to call this A and this B. yA is minus 4 minus yB is 2. My x coordinate is minus 5 minus 1. And what I get is, I'm going to simplify the top, minus 4 subtract negative 2, subtracting a negative is adding a positive. So we get negative 2 over negative 6. So here, I'm not done yet. The slope here is, I'm going to multiply both top and bottom by negative 1. That turns that into 2 over 6. A negative over a negative. After all, this is just a fraction. So here I have the slope is 2 over 6. What we generally like with slope is for it to be in lowest rational form. That is, let us reduce this fraction. Both top and bottom have a factor of 2. So if I divide both top and bottom by 2, I get 1 over 3. Now, what does that mean? It means that if I go over 1, 2, 3 units in my x, y is going to go up by 1. And what we see, there it is.